Hi guys, I have to tell you something. I did a terrible mistake and I pushed my password into our remote Git repository. How on earth could that happen to me? I mean, I just wanted to finish changes and leave, and I typed git push, hit return, and in the next moment a cold hand of fear touched my heart. I left my password in the code, which I used for debugging. And now it's out there. What should I do? That was exactly the situation I faced some weeks ago, and to be honest, I didn't really know what to do now, so I had to Google in my despair, looking for a quick solution. And this is the first lesson I learned. Do not panic. Take a couple of deep breaths, wipe the sweat off, and bear with me. This can happen to everyone, and my guess is that this happens more often than we think. Okay, first step, we have to control the damage. Keep in mind, the moment a secret string leaves your machine, it must be considered compromised. So if there is any sensitive information in your commit, then change it immediately. That means revoke any API keys or tokens and change your passwords. Why? There are bots out there that crawl public repositories constantly and scrape for these informations within minutes. That's why it's so urgent to control the damage. After you changed everything, get yourself a coffee and relax for a moment. Everything that follows now is just cosmetics and just hides the traces of our embarrassing failure. We could end the video now because changing the passwords did already 99% of the job. Often one tend to think that we can just overwrite our plain password in the code and add a new commit to the repository. However, this is not enough because of the history of Git. Don't forget, Git keeps track of every code change, including your breach of course. The password would still be visible in the commit history. In the following, we will differentiate two different use cases. Use case number one. Your password has been pushed in the most recent commit. You just realized immediately after you hit push, like I did. That's the easiest and the most common situation where we can find ourselves in. What we can do here is locally change our last commit and replace it. In Git speech, altering a commit is a commit amend. So what we do is cleaning up the code, stage it, and amending our most recent commit. The no edit flag indicates that we just want to keep our commit message. After that, we want to bring the changed commit to our remote repository. Here we need to push. A simple push would fail because Git will see the local amended commit and the remote commit as diverged content. Remember, we have changed what lies already remotely. That's why we must politely insist a little bit more and do a git push force with lease, which is a bit safer than a push force. And that's it. A little side note here. If you have opened the old version of your commit in your browser, you will see something very interesting. After your push, GitHub, for example, will tell you that this commit is no longer part of your history. That makes sense because you kicked it out with a brand new commit that has a new hash number. So everything worked out. And now let's address the hard one, use case number two. Your commit lies a couple of commits in the past. We all know code evolves over time, and you or your coworkers could have added new features into the repository. Many commits have been made after. And after a week or two, you realize that your password has been baked into the code. This makes things a slightly tricky situation to erase your password from the commit history. What we do next is we talk to our coworkers. Be open because, as I said in the beginning, these things happen, so you should not remain silent in shame. Code should not be the responsibility of one person alone anyways, right? Ask your colleagues to close their open pull requests originating from the branch your password lies in and maybe stash their current work. Why is such a dramatic step necessary? The reason here is that we are going to change the entire history until the point you check your password in. And this could result in some unwanted behavior if someone wants to merge another branch back in. The easiest thing here is to close PRs at this point. Now, let's go through the steps that are necessary to repair your repository. First of all, you must identify the commit that brought you in this miserable situation. Show the logs for that and copy the hash ID of this particular commit. The next thing we do can be compared to a time traveler, changing history and propagating these changes over time into present. I hope that analogy works for you guys. Changing history in Git can be achieved with Rebase. That functionality should be used with caution, but we are already in an emergency situation, so let's do it. We are rebasing from our dangerous commit ID into the direction of the most recent one. Adding the minus I option to Git Rebase allows you to run Rebase interactively. This gives you the opportunity to alter individual commits in the process. So what do I mean by that? An editor opens up and asks us which commits are about to be altered. Here we can either leave the prefix to pick, which does nothing to the commit, drop to erase that commit from the history, or edit, which is what we want, to edit the commits. These are the steps in time where our time traveler halts and modifies things. So after this command, the code changes to the point of your old commit. Maybe some memories pop up now, but no time for nostalgia. Let's move on, we are almost there. We repair our code and do what we have already seen, staging code and commit amend. Because remember, again we need to alter a commit that we have already done, but nothing new. Then we must get into our time machine again and hop to the next commit that we labeled with edit. This can be done with a rebase continue. Since we only marked one commit, the process jumps immediately to its end to the most recent commit and we are through. Finally, we must bring the changes to our remote repository. Here it might happen that a force release is not enough, so we need a force push. If you ask me, I would always try a force release first. And we are done. Great job. You just undid the damage. Now you can ask your collaborators to do a clean pull from that branch and continue with their work. In the beginning of the video, I told you that these kinds of issues occur more often than we think, right? How do I know that? I know because there are some tools out there solving exactly what we just did manually. One great example is the BFG Repo Cleaner. It's an open source tool written in Scala and it can support you in, for example, nuking unwanted files or replacing specific strings entirely from your history. Isn't that handy? And now, share your experience with me. Did you find yourself in such a pity situation before? And what exactly did you do? Looking forward to read your horror stories. Thanks for watching.